our last video, we covered how to parse HTML with beautiful soup, which was exactly as delicious as it sounds. But what about parsing something other than HTML? What about parsing CSS? Those are entirely different letters from HTML! I feel like I'm losing my mind! To help us get back on track, here's Professor of Innovation Neil Amy and guest lecturer Oleg Zeidener!
Thank you so much, Dean. Oleg, thanks for being here today. Can you please tell us why we would use CSS selectors when parsing data when we're doing web scraping?
I think this is one of the most popular ways to work with scraping. CSS initially were invented to do styles for HTMLs. So every time you go to the website and you see like beautiful colors and fonts, everything, it's made by CSS. And parsing made also very possible using exactly the same way. So as a designer, they put different attributes and colors or whatever to the pages. We as scrapers can use exactly the same way to find exactly the piece of the HTML page we want to extract.
Got it. Okay, can you show us how to do this on our site and how it all works?
Yeah, absolutely. So we have here is some example of web scraping with CSS selector, and we have some kind of like articles website with articles.
Excellent. This is the page I get all my news from.
Dean, this isn't a real news website.
I know. It's so much more refreshing than the tragedy and horror of actual news.
This is on our pleasescrape.com website, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Please scrape. So you can really scrape it as you want. And here how it looks in the code. So we're already familiar with the beautiful soup, and we used LXML before as a parser to extract all the HTML. But CSS is even simpler. So we do exactly the same response request as we did before, HTML content. And then we use beautiful soup, but we don't need to use LXML anymore. It's usually work faster. Again, if you do scraping at super big scale, it can be a good idea for you. And how it works. If you remember from previous classes, we use soup.find to find some elements of HTML. We use select. And then we use exactly the same language as CSS. So for example, let's look at CSS, right? Do we have it some here? This is example of the CSS inside of every modern HTML page you go into scrap, you find it. So they say everything that is class card should be padding, margin top, font size, etc., etc.
So if I may interrupt, Oleg. So I'm understanding that we're going to parse by kind of targeting these CSS items that we see here. But when I look at these, like card and card title, I don't see the text like of the title, for example. Can you explain how that kind of works and translate to the actual text we're trying to get, the title of the text?
Yeah, very good question. Right, I always make an assumption so it's easy, but it's not. So let's look for this card title, for example, right? And if you look here, so we have this card title, the font size should be bold and here, right? And if you're looking through the HTML, we can find this element. This is a class card title, and we have here, we can find all the elements by class. And this is how they are referenced in the CSS by same thing. This is what we're going to do with our beautiful soup with CSS type. So before we used to do soup.find, but now we use select because it's CSS select. This is the language of CSS. And we can put .card and print all the titles. Or we can have a card text and print all the summaries of our news or image sources, right? This is how it works. And another option we can use with selectors is going by ID. If you use a hashtag, is ID. If you use a dot before the thing, is a class.
Awesome. Thanks so much, Oleg. So now, Dean, you know everything there is to know about getting and parsing a basic website. You have the foundational knowledge, but there's more to scraping than what we've shown so far. Websites get more advanced from here, and this is where we're going to need a more sophisticated library like Scrapy to help us take it to the next level.
Well, that was complicated, but surely now we know everything we need to know to scrape a web page. Absolutely everything. No way could there be anything else whatsoever that we need to know.
Well...
I knew it! Students, tune in next time to learn all about how to parse XPath with me and the professors. Until then, don't forget to check the description of this video for links to the code we used today, the written version of this lesson, and many more useful resources. Don't forget!